Hi everyone, this is Angel.
And I'm Jeremy.
Yeah, today's topic is 看护好财务
Looking after your valuables.
Yeah.
Okay, this is something that we might need to do if you're going on the road.
Yes, in the public.
That's right. And if you're staying in a hotel,
mm-hmm.
These are the sort of times when you put things in safes to protect them.
Yeah.
Okay, we just saw in the dialogue there, they weren't very careful about their valuables, right?
Yes. 我要寄存贵重物品。
I'd like to check in some valuables.
我们有保险箱。
We've got a safe that you can use.
请帮我锁好。
Please help me to secure my things.
好的，请记住您箱子的密码。
Okay, please remember your PIN number for your safe.
Yeah, he is careful.
He's very careful.
Yeah, to check in some valuables, but he's brave.
Brave and also a bit careless though with the money at the end there, leaving his money on the case.
Yeah, just want to catch the thief. Yeah. Okay, let's see, 20 points.
Okay.
The first one is 有.
Right, 有.
有.
我要寄存贵重物品。
我们有保险箱。
And this means to have or to possess something. It's fairly simple. Let's see the first example.
Okay. 我有一只宠物狗。
Okay.I have a pet dog. To possess or own it, I have it. So, yeah.
Oh, really?
Actually, I do.
Yes, I do. 他有一份好工作。
He has a good job.
Yeah.
He possesses it. He has it. Simple.
Yes. Another language point is,
okay.
请。
请。Now, 请。
请帮我锁好。
好的，请记住您箱子的密码。
Is please. A lot of people think that Chinese don't say please very much, but there is a word for it. It's 请. So let's have a look at the example.
Okay. 请帮我拿一瓶水.
Please help me to get a bottle of water.
说话请文明点儿.
Please be a bit more civilized with your language. Okay?
Yeah, actually this is a warning.
It's a warning.
Yes. So please, Jeremy, give us some tips of today.
Okay, you're welcome. I'll happily give you some tips.
Yeah, okay.
First of all, let's look at some places where you might need to store your valuables.
Yeah.
And there's some obvious ones here, but there's some that you might not know about. So the first one is railway stations.
Yeah, 火车站。
火车站。And you would store your valuables there before going on a trip somewhere. There's, of course, travelling. There's another place you would store some things.
Yes.
And that would be at the...
ji chao.
The airport. Okay. Another place where you might want to put some possessions in a storage, come back and get them later.
Yes.
We have a last example here of a place where you might want to store things, and it's a very obvious one, and it's your hotel, or...
宾馆,
yeah, it stays in the hotel and you can store things there.
There's
one though that we're not quite used to seeing a lot of in the West, and that would be the supermarket.
Or that is 超市.
And in the 超市, you can store things in China because they're worried about you stealing things.
Actually, yeah, not only just to secure your things, just to secure the things of the supermarket.
That's it. Yeah.Okay, well that's pretty much the end of today's lesson.
Yeah, that's it.
And you can find a whole lot more material at mandarintube.com.
Yeah, your Chinese Learning Channel.
So we'll see you next time.
Yeah, welcome.
Bye.
Bye.
And when she lets me slip away